Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam. Today we're gonna cover 5 super obvious features that you either knew your whole life or you discovered them just now after 600 years of using 3ds Max. So let's dive deeper into the known unknown depths of 3ds Max. Our first feature is gonna be maxstart.max. So maxstart.max is a file that will be opened up every time when you open a fresh new copy of 3ds Max. So when you open Max instantly, it just opens like this. So everything is basic, everything is default. But if you go, for example, to render settings, you will notice that Arnold is our selected rendering engine. And if you're using V-Ray, Corona, F-Store, whatever, you would always need to change these parameters. Especially if you do, for example, a lot of interiors, you always have some similar setup on how you start to set up your scene. Well, you can do all that setup and Max will remember it. So if I change this to F-Storm, if, for example, I'm doing animation and if I right click here and I change my frame rate to PAL and let's say my amount of frames to 200, press OK, so these will be applied here. And on the other hand, if I need to change some settings in my render setup, some default stuff that I use, for example, light samples 12, max depth 24. If I want to add like an HDRI map, I can just click here and add a map, open up my material editor, drag it in, load some HDRI in it, and many other things that you do in your Max that kind of stay in that scene until the next time you open it. Well, if you do all those preparations in your fresh Max, and you go to File, Save As, and you go to your C drive and Documents, 3ds Max 2022, Scenes, and if you save here this file as Max Start, press save, the next time you open up your Max, like this, all these settings will be preserved. Look, my frame count is 200 frames. If I right click here, I'm at PAL frame rate. If I go to my render settings, you will see that F-Storm is my main default render. If I go to my environment, you will see my HDRI loaded in. And if I, in the end, go to my materials, you will see that that bitmap is loaded here also. So you can prepare your scene any way you like. And every time when you start a new instance of Max, that scene will be loaded up. And that can save a lot of time. Our second feature is going to be Paint Connect. Now, Paint Connect is a feature that is a part of the ribbon. Now, ribbon has millions of modeling features. So yeah, I'm going to cover one feature which I rarely see anywhere. So I'm guessing a lot of people don't know about it. So if you go to your edit poly and you have a cut tool, so whenever you want to cut something from here to here, here, you always have to aim, you know, and that aiming takes a lot of time. But if you go to your ribbon, you go to modeling section, you go to edit, there you have Paint Connect. So click on Paint Connect, and what it does, you can paint edges like using a regular brush. If you hold control, it's gonna snap only to vertices. So holding control now, it does this. But if you wanna do half snap, half freehand, you can hold control and then just release and paint whatever you like. So I find this method of cutting very useful. Don't get me wrong, I'm not using it all the time. So if you need to do a regular cut to cut from, you know, for example, from here to here, you have to, you know, watch where you click in so that you don't miss and do this. You can just use Paint Connect. I've added my Paint Connect to my quad menu. So for example, just a quick stroke and everything is connected. If I want to connect these, I can just do this, this, then start drawing here and then start connecting things. So it's a very handy and very simple tool to use. Our next feature is going to be Advanced Color Selector. Now, when you click on any color inside of Max, you get this boring old color selector, which has been here for 20 plus years and nothing has changed. But if you have Corona installed, you can go to Customize, Preferences, and here under the general section you can see color selector, so you can change that one to Corona improved picker. Now when you click on that and when you click on your color, you get this massive beautiful color picker with all different kinds of options. You can change your temperature colors here, your albedo values. You can even have this nice little color picker. If you click and hold that click, it's gonna constantly track colors, and it can even go beyond borders of max. So if you have some image that is, for example, on your Chrome or somewhere, you can just go to it and pick the color you want. Now, a really cool feature is, if you click here, you have 3x3 average, 5x5 average, etc. So what that means is it will select, for example, 11x11 pixels on the screen, and it will calculate its average color. So if we click on that and I click here and want to get an average color of this gray, as you can see, the colors here are not gonna violently start to change. They're actually gonna be very smooth. Unlike if I click to point sample and go here, you will see a big mess of colors happening. Corona's Color Picker is a definite recommendation for you to use in everyday life. Our next feature is gonna be material controllers. Now, this is a very fancy feature. So any bitmap in the material editor that you have, if you right click on it, you have show all additional parameters. So if you click that, you get this little additional menu. Now, if you click plus, your bitmap has all these options. But if you take a closer look, you will notice that all these options are also available here. So what is the point of this? Well, the point is, you can actually manipulate all of this outside of Corona Bitmap. Now, how is that fancy, or how is that important? So, if I right-click here, and if I go Show Hide Slots, click here. Now, if I want to manipulate the tiling of Corona Bitmap, I'm going to select UVV Scale. Now, after you select UVV Scale and you click plus, you will get this option here. Now, why is that option important? So what you can do is grab here, release, and select Bezier 0.3. So this will bring up this little node. And look at this. I have a multi-texture material here. So in my material, I have 5 different textures. I have the same thing with F-Storm here, but we'll get to F-Storm later. So you can just click here, drag here, release, and select UVV scale again. So UVV scale, like I said, this is styling. So if I link all these here, and when you need to change tiling for your multi-maps, instead of going into every and each one texture, you can just go here and change the tiling. So look at this. If I set my tiling to 0.5 instead of 1, we'll see all of them change. If I set this one to 5, all of them will change. So if you click here, you will see the values 0.5, 5. If you click here, 0.5, 5. If I change this 5 to 2, you will see that value changing here also. And now you can link all the parameters and you can manipulate them however you want on various bitmaps. You can even connect this with multiple materials. Now, when it comes to F-Storm and materials in F-Storm, it's a very similar thing. So if you go here, additional parameters, you can just click tiling and you're gonna have the same thing. So in F-Storm, this is called tiling. In Corona, it's called UVV scale. But this specific action, you actually don't need these controllers. What you can do, you can actually select this node and link it directly here without adding any additional nodes. So let me just bring this here. You link these, and you get the same thing. So now, if you want to change your tiling from 1 to 0.5, it's going to happen here, as you can see. If you want to change your V tiling to 5, it's going to be like this. Now, F-Storm has these things automated, but it generally affects the whole rollout. But if you want some things to be automated and some things to be with different values on each bitmap, then you're going to probably use the same thing and just link it to some of these features that are offered here. And our last feature will be Use Transform Coordinate Center. Now, we're talking about this feature here. So, I bet a lot of you know what these two features do, but let me just do a quick recap. If you have this feature selected and you select multiple objects, when you try to rotate them, everyone is gonna rotate in their own direction. If you wanna scale them, everyone will scale separately. Now, if you select the next option, it will just calculate the middle value and you can just do this or do this. But what does the third option do? So if you select one of these and you turn on snap, now you can see the little yellow plus icon. I hope you see it. And if you want to rotate it, it will rotate around the point that you selected. So if I snap here, it will rotate around this point. The same thing goes with the scale. If I switch to scale mode, it will scale from the bottom up. If I go here, it will just scale from this point. So this is a really cool feature and you can do a lot of things with it. And that's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed today's depths. I hope you're deeper than you ever were before. If you know a feature that a lot of people don't know about, don't hesitate to share it in the comments, and see you in the next video. Bye.